All right, you guys, so for today's video, we're gonna be showing you guys something really cool. No matter if you're short like me, or if you're a little bit taller, we're gonna have a cool little mod for you guys if you guys do own a Tacoma like I do. So if you guys are interested, make sure to stay tuned. Let's get into it and show you what it is. All right, you guys, so what I have right here in my hand is gonna be the Desert Does It Seat Jackers. So right now I'm gonna show you guys exactly how it works. But if you come right over here, this thing is awesome. Reason why is because, so if you notice right here, the brachia is actually on the carpet. So what this bad boy does, it acts like a spacer. So it's gonna go in between there, essentially raising the seat. So if you guys are short, once again, like me, you're gonna notice this seat does kind of go straight forward. And if you guys do have like a 2016 to a 2019 Tacoma, you guys will know what I'm talking about. If you're short, you can't really see over the hood here because it's very low. So when you add that on, it's gonna actually raise your seat. Of course, my Tacoma is a 2020, which essentially it should have the power seats that raise up. But since I did recently just install these brand new aftermarket seats, they do sit a little bit lower. So I'm gonna add those in to kind of bring it up for me so that way I can see perfectly and just be really, really comfortable in these seats. If you guys do wanna watch that video, it'll be in the description box below. But I do just kind of wanna give you guys a quick look as far as the seats. You can see they're kind of straightforward. So once it raises me, I'll try it after. But before we do that, I'm gonna get my niece in here so that way she can kind of tell you guys how she feels as well. So go ahead and hop back in here and then we'll ask you some questions. Okay. So once you hop in, you're gonna notice, I don't know if you remember how the old seats were, but they were a little bit higher. On these brand new ones, I don't know if you feel the seat, it just kind of feels too straight, right?
Yeah.
Literally anybody can do it. And you just need two things. You're gonna need a size 15 millimeter socket to go ahead and remove this. And then you're also gonna need a size 14 millimeter socket. So it's gonna be super, super simple. Nothing too hard. Literally anybody can do it. So let's get to it. You ready?
Yeah, let's go.
Let's go. All right, you guys, so the first thing we're gonna need to do is get our size 14 millimeter socket and wrench. As far as for me, I do have a power tool. I'd say try to do it by hand first. You don't want to break anything, but go ahead and grab that first. And then we're going to remove four bolts that are on the seat. So let's hop right over here and I'll show you guys what I'm talking about. So you're going to notice there's one bolt that's going to be right there. That's going to be a size 14 millimeter socket. So once you have that one out, you're going to notice on the opposite side there, you're going to have one more of that size 14 millimeter socket. Might be hard to see because of the lighting, but there's one more right there. Go ahead and take that out.
All right, so now you're gonna have to take out two more bolts. So if you have a floor mat, move that, and then you'll see the two bolts. They're the same size, and just take them out. Now that you took the two bolts from the back off, you're gonna move the seat to the back to give you space. And we're gonna put the two spacers on, and you'll see in the next clip.
All right, so now that you've done that, the next thing you're gonna notice on your actual seat jackers, which if you want them, description box below, there's gonna be like a little nipple coming out of it on both of these. And one thing I did wanna let you guys know is you guys can purchase for both seats. As far as for me, I just wanted it for the driver's seat. If I really do like them, maybe down the road I'll buy it for the passenger seat, but this is gonna be just the driver one, but it's gonna be the same exact installation. So once you figure out where the nipples are, which are there, you're gonna wanna notice right here, if you come in a little bit closer, you're gonna see there's a threaded hole. And then there's gonna be a hole with a white piece there. But what you're gonna wanna do with the white piece, go ahead and pull it out. If you need a panel removal tool to do it, go ahead and do that. Now you can go ahead and insert it and it should freely go in. So now that we've have that one in place, go ahead and grab one of your bolts and you're gonna notice there's two threadings here. So there's gonna be this threaded here, which is gonna be for the new hardware. And down here, you're gonna wanna reinstall the same bolt that you had taken off. So I'm gonna do it by hand for now. And we'll leave it there. And then you're gonna go ahead and grab the other side. One thing I did wanna say, these guys really thought of safety in mind. The reason I say that is because if you notice here, this isn't super thick. This would be kind of as thick as your actual factory seat is. So your bolt will still have enough thread to thread in. And then they actually provide you the brand new bolt, which is where your seat is gonna sit now. So that's pretty cool. And then of course, that's what helps with adjustment. And another thing I do wanna point out, which you'll see right here in the front, this one has it as well. Right here in the front, it is also threaded. And if I'm not mistaken, they do sell like a MOLLE type panel that you can install. So once you have it like say in there, the Molly panel will go right here. You install that, and then you could put like a fire extinguisher or just any other things you want to mount on that. So this company is actually pretty cool in my eyes. This isn't sponsored. I'm just letting you guys know what I think of them. Once you have these in their position and you have them hand tight, now you go ahead and get your 14 millimeter socket, tighten those down, and then we can bring down the seat and put the brand new bolts there and reinstall the back. All right, so now that you have those brackets in its place, now you want to go ahead and bring down your seat, and you're going to align it with the top holes here. Your bolts went down here from the factory. New ones are going to go up here. So in the hardware bag that it comes with in those brackets, there's going to be these two bolts, which are going to go in there. Do it by hand first. You don't want any cross-threading. So I have this one just for now, and then we'll go ahead and start the other one as well, and then we'll move on to the back. So the bolts back here, it's going to be the same ones you had taken off, which is the factory ones. All right, you guys, so now that we have the seat jackers installed, once again, if you want them, description box below. I did want to point out a cool thing about these bad boys right here is this is also going to help you with your lower back if you guys are on longer road trips. Reason why is because since it now it is up in the front, it helps support your legs. So that way you don't get lazy leg or whatever they call it and your back starts hurting. So with this, it'll help support you in a good position, and now you can have your back super straight and it'll be super comfortable. And if I'm not mistaken, I think this company actually promotes it that way as well. But just letting you guys know, let's go ahead and now get to the review and the measurements of this. So if I'm measuring it from here where this bracket starts, it's about 9.5 inches higher. Let's go ahead and now go to the other side. We're going to measure the passenger side. This side is basically stock. They're the same exact seat. They have the same exact brackets. So we'll be able to get a side-by-side comparison. So this one should be about 1.5 inches smaller. Let's check it out. And sure enough, it is roughly. So there you guys go. So if you guys do want it, there it is. And you can even tell straight up. I mean, right here, this seat is straight. The one over there, it's nice and curved. So I might end up buying them for this side as well, but let's go ahead and now get to the review part. All right, you guys, so now that you've bolted all the bolts down, the ones right here in the front are all secured, everything's good to go. Test out your seat, make sure it works, but let's show you guys now. So if you guys do see, before I was sitting, it was like about down here somewhere, and now I feel super comfortable. I can see nice and straight, everything is awesome, and I still fit pretty good. So I can go either forward, backward, it's no problem. So let's go ahead and let my niece sit in it and see what she thinks about it. But what do you think for someone short? You think that's worth it, or what do you think? Can you feel the difference, or can you not?
I think it feels more comfortable for sure.
Yeah, right?
It feels better.
A lot more how my a legs seat should still, sit.
Yeah.
So would you recommend it to short people?
I would recommend it. I can see better.
But you have to say it to short people?
I recommend it to short people and to tall people and to people of any size.
So it's, you still fit fine?
Yeah, I fit good.
Heck yeah. Yeah, and the reason it doesn't really mess if you're tall or not is because it's only raising the front. So literally just bringing this piece up. So it'll give you like a more comfort level versus if you were to put some in the back, then of course it would bring that whole seat up and then you'd be hitting the roof if you were taller. But this, it just helps you out. So if you guys do end up wanting it, it's going to be in the description box below. And once again, if you do want to see this install video on the seats, it'll be in the description box below. So if you guys did like today's video, please make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. We'll see you guys on the next one. Bye bye.
You're supposed to say peace.
I know. Jesse Rizzo is here for you. It's here for you. Feel free to subscribe.